Good morning, Eagle Nation. Today is Friday. We've made it this far. We can make it to the end. It's also the 98th day of school and the 9th day of the third quarter. Please join me in starting this Friday with just a moment of silence. Thank you. And now, your Friday song for announcements. You asked for it, you got it.
Yo, VIP. Let's kick it. Ice, ice, baby. Ice, ice, baby. All right, stop. Collaborate and listen. I sit back with my brand new invention. Something grabs a hold of me tightly. Flow like a hawk daily and nightly.
Will it ever stop?
Yo, I don't know. Turn off the lights and I'll glow.
Good morning, Eagle Nation. Let's do this thing
called Friday.
Wherever you may be, please stop, please stand, let's rise together for this morning's pledge of allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated. It's Friday. We rest our bodies, but not our minds. If you've been in school and keeping track, and I hope that you are, teachers, you could write on the board that it's the 98th day of school overall. That's the year-to-date, YTD, year-to-date. Quarter three, though, is the 9th day of school. So, for you students who are keeping track out of there and want to keep measure your own attendance, it's the number of days you've attended in quarter three divided by the number of days possible. So what last week was out of 4 days, we would change this denominator and make it the number of days you've attended, which hopefully is not 1, 2, 3, or 4. Hopefully it's 7, 8, or 9. Maybe 9 would be best. But change the denominator to 9 possible days. And then simply divide the numerator into the denominator. So 1/9 becomes 1 divided by 9. 2/9 becomes 2 divided by 9. 3/9 becomes 3 divided by 9. And 4/9 becomes 4 divided by 9. 4 divided by 9. The rest is a math problem we'll look at more closely on a different day perhaps, or you can take a look as a class for a 5-minute mini lesson on how to divide, convert fractions into decimals. They're equivalent to decimal form and then to a percent. But I hope you're doing just that. We're getting closer and closer to celebrating the Lunar New Year for those of us that celebrate. And my daughter made this for me last night. This is a little good luck charm. This time she put a horse on it because one of my daughters was born in the year of the horse. But this is the year of the rabbit, if you've been paying attention. So wish somebody Happy New Year if they celebrate the Lunar New Year. And as they say in Vietnam, we say in my household, Chúc Mừng Năm Mới. And so you could also come and join at Indian Steel Park this weekend. There is a culture festival going on with food, dance, music, prizes, games. It's all happening at Indian Steel Park, which is about 1 mile up the road. I believe it's on both Saturday and Sunday. So look that up and please be there. It'd be fun to see you. I'll probably see you there. In addition to that, our writing contest continues. What have you learned from love and loss? I just started reading Out of My Mind last night by Sharon Draper, along with our fourth grade class. And I don't know how it's going to go yet, but I'm reading it along with you, and I'm curious to see where the story leads us. You still have about 2 weeks to complete and submit your essay, and I hope that many of you do at all grade levels. Special thank you to Kimberly. Kimberly, I want to let you know I got this fantastic note, and what a great way to start any kind of day. This is a little book that Kimberly made with reasons why she loves Emerson. She has written in it. Great job practicing your writing, Kimberly, and also illustrated it. Check that out. Thank you so much, Kimberly. I'm gonna hang on to this. What a great way to start my day. If you didn't get donuts, Steph, be sure that you do. Ms. Talamante has provided those for you just as a pick-me-up. For you students, though, we're going to do a special raffle today at the end of the day. We always do a raffle on Friday, but today we'll do a special raffle that's limited to the 10 teachers for the teacher side of things from yesterday, plus any that are submitted today. We'll do a raffle for any of these that are submitted today based upon the names of teachers that are submitted. And I've got some things here today to raffle off. As often we do, we have coffee to raffle off for teachers. I've got four gift cards, $10 a piece. And also, I thought I would pick up some eggs because eggs are so dadgone expensive that we're going to raffle off some eggs as well. And I have several cartons of these. But if your name is called teachers at the end of the day, you get to choose. Do you want coffee? Do you want eggs? It's on me. Students, it is Handful Friday. So if your name is called at the end of the day, you'll get to come up to the office and as much as you can carry in a single handful without dropping it, that's how much you get to take with you. It's a great day to make friends because, you can share that, but that's up to you. Also, what's going on? Our attendance. I spoke to it a little bit, but I always want to give you our update. We saw a little uptick Wednesday we were at 85.3. So how do we do on Thursday? Attendance overall for the school was 93.8, which as you already know, is getting closer and closer to 96%. It's gonna be harder to move our year-to-date percentage to get that to 96, because we have to actually be above 96 to do it, which we can do. But this one's getting closer to 96, and that's the right place to start. So excellent job being here, staying healthy, wearing masks, keeping your hands clean, being here, not just being here, but being here on time. We do notice, and we do appreciate you students for doing that, and we're gonna celebrate you at the end of quarter three. Other things going on, Student of the Month celebrations. Our Student of the Month should already have been turned in. Teachers, if you haven't done so, please be sure that you do. And now, let's get to some words of wisdom so you can get to the business of teaching and learning. And as we celebrate this Lunar New Year, this particular wisdom comes to us from China. It is about the topic of sharing responsibilities. We talked about these geese now. This will be the third time we've talked about those geese, the ones that fly in the V. And there's still more to learn from them. When the lead goose gets tired, she moves to the back, relaxes, and lets another goose lead for a while. There's a scientific principle behind this that has to do with Bernoulli's principle. But beyond the science, the Chinese understand the wisdom in this way. They say, no matter how stout, one beam cannot support a house. In other words, no matter how strong, one goose cannot be the leader for the entire trip, any more than one beam can hold up an entire house. Many hands make light work. So if you've been carrying the biggest load and need a rest, remember to ask for help or give someone else a chance to be a leader. If on the other hand, you've been following too much and not sharing the work, step forward and be a leader. With something to think about, this is Mr. Lodato. Mask up today as needed. Hand sanitized and stay healthy. Hats, hoods, and sunglasses off indoors. Stay in your zones. Put away your phones. And make it a great day or not. The choice is yours.
To the extreme, I rock a mic like a vandal. Light up a stage and wax a chump like a candle. Dance. Caress a speaker that booms. I'm killing you.